Hello children, it's summer story time. Would you like to spend a night in a den full of hungry lions? This story is about a man who is given a choice. Either stop praying to God or be fed to the lions. Oh dear.
Daniel was taken away from his home to serve the king of Babylon. God's family had ignored God again and again, but Daniel wanted to live as God's friend. "There's only one living God," he said, "and I'll obey." So he went to his room to pray every day. Daniel trusted, obeyed, and worked very hard, and the king of Babylon put him in charge. But the other king's servants were jealous of Dan. They wanted him gone, so they came up with a plan. "Daniel works hard and is good at his job. We'll never find anything that he's done wrong. But he loves his God. Have you seen how he prays? If we want him to go, his God's laws are the way. Let's tell the king, 'O great majesty, you're the greatest one here. We must all bow the knee. Anyone who prays to anyone but you will be thrown to the lions. Sign here to make it true.'" The king was quite pleased. He thought, "Ooh, that's quite nice," and he signed on the line, but it wasn't at all wise. Daniel knew the king couldn't answer a prayer. There is only one God. There's no question there. But what would he do? If he didn't obey, he'd be thrown to the lions. He would die straight away. But Daniel knew he must follow God, not this law, so he got down on his knees and prayed to God like before. And those sneaky king's servants went and caught Daniel praying and went to the king angrily saying, "That Dan doesn't care about the king's rule. He's praying to God as if you were a fool." The king knew his law was an awful mistake and worked all day long to help Daniel escape. But he couldn't save Daniel, he had to admit, and his friend was thrown to the lion's pit. How the king worried all through the night. "Please, God, if you can, save Daniel tonight." And joy, in the morning, he found Dan safe and sound. God's angel had shut up the lions' mouths. The king said to Dan, "Now I know that there's only one living God. I've been foolish and proud, but he saved you, his man." The king was so angry with his jealous servants, he had them thrown to the lions, who had them for breakfast. And now the whole kingdom would hear the great news. There's only one living God. Make sure it's him you choose.